Captain's Log. Stardate, 7. I got really bored, so I started watching Naruto again on Netflix.
Don't tell Hulu.
Also, I found out how to make Krabby Patties with the food replicator. Believe it or not, the secret ingredient is...
Incoming hail, Captain.
Ah, hail. To be continued. On screen, Uheardher.
Roger.
It's from Roger? Finally! That two-faced son of a Galactus has owed me $2 for the past 3 years.
No, sir. I was just... Never mind.
Greetings. This is Captain Kurt of the Fraternity of Planets, one of the most handsome people alive, whose face was made into a mask and used by a serial killer later.
Ah, well, that might be helpful at Trivia Night. I'm some guy, captain of the USS ship.
What do you mean, some guy? Don't you have a real name?
Nope, I'm not important enough to have one, so that's the best the writer could come up with. Here, take a look in the script.
I would, but I can only read things that are in Latin.
Why?
I have no idea.
Alright, well, my ship sucks because I've got this kid on here, and he needs some sort of father figure. And as you can see, I'm incredibly ugly.
Believe me, I know.
Would you mind taking care of him? He even has his own tragic backstory.
I love tragic backstories. I bought one off of eBay. It goes like this. I was marooned in the middle of Sector 25.4 all alone on a ship by myself when a pack of space rabbits saved me. We became very close. I saw them as my adopted parents, but they didn't understand what I was saying because they could only speak in French. Then they died, and left a fortune behind for me, only to have it stolen by George Clooney, and now I'm here.
I don't think any of that actually made any sense.
You had to be there.
So will you take the kid?
I mean, I've got nothing better to do, so may as well.
We'll beam him over immediately. Thank you, Captain.
Always willing to help out those who are less fortunate in the looks department.
Oh, and by the way, his name is Charlie Y.
Why would you name him that? Ha, get it?
Shut up.
Wait a second. That's the name of the episode. How convenient. Yes, Captain. Almost as if it were planned that way. Yeah. I don't get it. Also, Captain, have you had the chance to check out Catch 22? It's on Hulu right now. Thank you, Hulu. Ah, ghost!
Sir, that's just Charlie.
Oh, I see. Hey, do any of you know when the title's... Space, the second to last frontier. These are the voyages of the starship Renterprise, its 5-year mission that is likely to end after 3 seasons to explore strange new pizza recipes, to seek out new pizza, and yeah, it's just about finding pizza. To boldly go where no video game character has gone before.
Well, Kurt, the boy seems to check out all right. No diseases. He likes cherry popsicles. But there's something weird here on this medical report.
What is it, Bonehead?
He seems to like Star Wars more than Star Trek.
My goodness! Well, not everyone is as perfect as I am. It's all right to be different, Charlie, as long as you can agree with all of my opinions.
Yes, sir.
Charlie, people didn't like you very much on your old ship, did they?
No, sir. But how did you know?
It's pretty obvious, really. Plus, I read ahead in script.
Wait, Bonehead, could I get a copy of that? No one sent it to me.
Oh, I, lost it.
Was that not it there in your hands a moment ago?
That was a recipe for fried Oreos.
Now that does make sense. Well, Charlie, why don't I show you around the Renterprise? Be careful, though. It is a rental.
That'd be great, Dad.
Cool. Wait, did you just call me Dad?
Nah, I didn't, Dad.
Alright, cool. Wait. And here is Irishy's quarters. Best be careful, though. He has a bunch of illegal copies of The Hunger Games: Mockingjay Part 1. And if you even have a single illegal copy of The Hunger Games: Mockingjay Part 1 in Canada, you'll be arrested on the spot.
Wow, this ship is really great. Especially better than my old ship, where they used to bully me and throw water balloons filled with antifreeze at me.
You're welcome here as a friend, Charlie, until you do something bad and become a villain. And don't worry, we're all out of antifreeze. Hula made some antifreeze soup last night and used it all up. It's actually better than you expect. I only died a few times after drinking it.
That makes sense, yeah. Who wouldn't like any free soup?
Exactly. Charlie, we may have only just met, but I see you as a son, son.
Well, thanks, Dad.
I've never had a son before. What do dads do with their kids? Oh, I've got it. Martial arts, of course. Let's throw down. Whoa, hey guys, it's like straight up looking like Stephen Chow's Kung Fu Hustle poster from Shang-Chi and the Legend of the Ten Rings official trailer. Hi-ya! Great Scott! Did you call me, Captain? No, Irishy. Your name is Irishy in this one, not Scotty. Oh yeah. Charlie, did you just break his neck?
Maybe?
Charlie. That was pretty awesome, actually. But I think he's dead, which is pretty bad, I guess. This is quite a predicament, because karate is cool, but murder isn't cool. Dang, Charlie, you're making my head spin.
Well, Dad, all you have to do is stop turning your head so much.
Ah, good point.
Holy Toledo, Jim. I just got the alert that someone frickin' died in here, man. What the heck happened?
Bonehead, please watch your language around the kid.
Sorry, Jim. What the hell happened?
Much better. Thanks, Bonehead. Well, Charlie killed someone.
Great Scott!
Did you call for me, sir?
What? No. How many times do we have to tell you? Your name is Irishy.
Oh yeah, that's right. Wait, and who's Scott?
Hey all, Scott here.
I'm guessing that's Scott. Jim, what are you going to do about the kid now that he's a murderer?
Bonehead, it was only a red shirt.
Good point, Jim.
I'm thinking about getting father and son matching outfits, actually. Besides, you can fix the guy, right?
Damn it, Jim. I'm a doctor, not a necromancer. I'm still going to necromancy school. I'm only a level 1 necro student.
Well, whose fault was that?
The economy.
Then, take it up with the Monopoly man. I'm gonna spend the day with my son.
See you later, doctor.
Something's off about Charlie, but I can't place it. But maybe the murder has something to do with it.
Dang, Charlie, we're looking mad fresh, yo.
I feel like Robert Pattinson if his name was Charlie and he had an American accent.
I know exactly what you mean. Whoa, Charlie, look. Women.
Women?
Yeah, Charlie. Don't tell me you've never seen a woman before.
What are they like?
Oh, well, they're white guys, but different. More women. Hey, ladies. See what happens when you're the star of a popular TV series, Charlie?
Wow, women are great. They're so feminine.
Go ahead, Charlie. Respectfully talk to one of them. Because cool people respect other people. Unless they're jerks, then you can throw them into space. Remember the trouble.
I will, Dad.
Now go get her, Lion.
Yo, yo, I'm Yoman Rad. What's up, G?
Oh, I thought you were a woman.
Nah, man. Like, I'm Yoman, but really, dude, I'm a yo-woman. You know what I'm throwing down?
No, but I was wondering if you wanted to go out with me? We could go back to my quarters and do something.
Do what?
Something very private?
Oh, yeah? Do tell.
We could maybe...
Yeah?
Play Super Mario Galaxy 2 together?
Playing a single-player game together? That sounds like much fun, bro man. However, I have a strict rule about dating people named Charlie. Sorry, man, I'm gonna have to pass.
How'd you know my name is Charlie?
It's on your shirt, man.
What if I told you my full name was Charles? Please, I want to date you so badly. I've loved you ever since I saw you.
Charles is a pretty solid name, but sorry, man, you're like majorly creeping me out.
No, it's fine. We can be married and nothing will be creepy. I'll love you forever. You have to marry me.
Alright, man. You're gonna make me lose my cool. I said no.
No! You can't say no to Charlie Y! I am the most powerful being ever!
Whoa, Charlie. What's going on over here? It's getting majorly cringy over here. Be careful, Charlie. This might go on Spork's cringe compilation.
Too late, Jim.
She said no to me! To me! Charlie Y! No one says no to me!
Son, what has come over you? You were a good guy that just accidentally... very purposefully murdered someone. You have to respect a person's right to choose who they want to date.
What about my right?
The only right you have is to be thrown out into space.
I'd like to see you try, traitor! Oh, that was a good try.
Captain, do you ever wonder if pushing all of the villains out of the window will lead to some serious consequences?
Spork, I choose to live a life without consequences.
Captain, I do not think that is how—
Whatever, Spork. I thought my son was Captain America, you know? But he turned out to be the other guy, the main character of the Joker movie. What was his name again?
The Joker?
That doesn't sound right, but whatever. How could my son do this?
Captain, he was not actually your son.
Oh yeah, you're right. Screw that guy. Let's party again.